So in the last couple months, we've focused on some very basic concepts in general music theory. So today, we're going to start to move towards more jazz-focused music theory, talking about the structure of jazz. Much of what happens in jazz is strongly influenced by the rather rigid structure of the genre. But far from being an obstacle, the structure provides a set of agreed-upon rules of the game that allow musicians to come together and play jazz with little more advanced communication than is required to pick a tune and the key to play it in. Understanding this structure is essential to playing jazz well. The structure of jazz has three principal components: rhythmic, formal, and harmonic. The rhythmic component dictates fixed rhythmic relationships among the participating instruments. The formal component is based largely on popular song forms, which follow a few small, highly predictable patterns. The harmonic component is governed by a relatively small number of types of chord progressions. However, these chord progressions and the individual chords themselves are subject to a great deal of variation and elaboration, which accounts for much of the real complexity encountered in jazz. Accordingly, several sections of these lessons will be devoted to various aspects of jazz harmony, rhythm, and form will be treated. The rhythmic, harmonic, and formal components together confine jazz to a fairly narrow range of musical possibilities. Jazz has been criticized for these limitations, but it is this very confinement that allows several musicians to collaborate successfully in production of mostly improvised performances. The rhythmic structure of jazz. Rhythmically, jazz has three layers: melody, chords, and bass. These layers have more or less fixed rhythmic relationships. In the typical case, the bass part coincides with the beat, which is generally the quarter note. The melody often moves twice as fast or in eighth notes, while the chords typically change at half the rate of the bass or half notes. The rate at which chords change, the so-called harmonic rhythm, is sometimes halved or doubled, changed to whole notes or quarter notes within a piece. The realization of the three-layer structure is dependent on the available instrumental resources. Solo piano, duo, trio, combo, big band, etc. A solo pianist, for example, must either provide all three layers with two hands or else omit one layer. By contrast, a big band offers many ways to provide the three layers. Chords, for example, can be played by just the pianist or the guitarist, or by any combination of the available brass and or reed instruments. What is the function of percussion in the three-layered structure? To answer this question, it is necessary to look at each style, each individual group of artists, to see how percussion is actually employed. In the traditional piano trio, the ride cymbal or brushes are used primarily to blend and unify the sound of the piano and bass and to maintain continuity of sound. In Latin-oriented groups, percussion plays a foreground role that is essential to the character of the music. Often multiple percussionists are needed to realize the full rhythmic complexity of this type of music. In a big band, the drummer is essential both as a basic timekeeper and as the provider of much of the rhythmic punch of arrangements through hits, fills, and solo passages. Jazz has a unique rhythmic interpretation and character. This unique rhythmic character of jazz is generated mainly in the melodic or eighth note layer. This rhythm is not notated in jazz lead sheets, scores, and parts, but must rather be supplied as an interpretation by the performer. This interpretation is focused on the treatment of eighth notes. The following example would not sound like jazz if it was literally as written at the tempo from roughly 60 to medium up jazz tempos. So here we go. This is this excerpt without swing. Now, instead, at tempos in this range, this passage would be played something like the following. Depending on the performer, the eighth note triplet might be slightly accented. This treatment of eighth notes is one of the key elements that gives jazz its characteristic swing. Swing cannot be notated exactly. It is learned by listening to more experienced musicians and then attempting to capture the same feel in one's own playing. Whenever eighth notes occur in the bass or chord layers, the same rhythmic interpretation used in the melodic layer applies. As the tempo is increased into the fast bebop range, the usual interpretation of the eighth notes increasingly approaches the straight eighth notes of the first example above. Never be correct to play music like this as written, although jazz is occasionally notated like this. The dotted 8th-16th rhythm is considered square by jazz musicians. This example would instead be played with the 8th note triplet feel of the preceding example. With slower pieces, which jazz musicians generally call ballads, the notated rhythm is interpreted quite freely. The techniques used include rubato and other alterations of the given note values, playing behind the beat and playing out of time, that is, without a discernible beat or pulse. So moving on to form. Jazz inherited much of its formal structure from early music. The typical jazz performance is a type of theme and variation, a form which goes back centuries in European music. In the jazz version of theme and variation, a performance begins with the statement of a pre-composed melody, often a pop standard or a familiar jazz tune, which jazz musicians call the head. This constitutes the theme part of the theme and variations. The theme or head is then followed by an indefinite number of improvised variations on the theme. These improvised choruses generally follow the structure and harmony of the original theme quite closely. Normally, each soloist will take his or her turn playing one or more choruses. However, several soloists may share one or more improvised choruses by trading fours or trading eighths. In this case, the soloists improvise in round-robin fashion on four or eight-bar segments of the form. It is traditional to finish off a performance with a restatement of all or part of the original head tune. More elaborate versions of the jazz version of theme and variation form may include an introduction, one or more interludes, and either a short tag or an extended coda section. The form of the theme itself is generally one of a smaller number of stock patterns that are found in all types of popular music. So the first form type is AABA. By far the most common song form is the 32-bar AABA form. In this form, where there are two different 8-bar sections called A and B, the A section is played twice and typically has first and second endings. The first ending generally contains a turnaround, a passage designed to lead back to the opening of a tune. The second ending often modulates to the key of the B section, or bridge. At the end of the bridge, there is generally a modulation back to the key of the A section. Here is a list of some popular standards that have AAB structure. So let's choose one of these as an example. So for example, when we take the song Lullaby of Birdland, we can very clearly hear this AAB structure. So here's the A. Then we repeat A. When we finish A, the ending is a bit different, and we go on to B. Now we return to A. Our next form is ABAC. It's another common song form. This form has 4 8-bar sections grouped into 2 16-bar units, which are often identical except for their respective endings. Here's a list of some popular standards that have ABAC form. We're going to take a look at Embraceable You. So here's our A. And it's going to move into B. Back to A. finishing off with C. Our next form type is through composed. A small number of songs is through composed. That is, they consist of one big section that runs from beginning to end, although the melody may still be organized as 4 8-bar units, so yielding what you might refer to as an A, B, C, D, so no repetition within the theme. This form does not preclude a certain amount of thematic repetition. Three well-known through-composed songs are Avalon, Stella by Starlight, and You Do Something to Me, which you'll be able to hear on our listening list.
I found my love in Avalon, beside the bay. I left my love in Avalon and sailed away. I dream of her.
Ternary form is our final form, and a much smaller number of tunes use ternary form, also known as ABA form. As with AABA form, this form has two different sections, but the A section is not repeated before the B section. I'll Remember April is one of the best-known popular standards in ternary. So what is the role of song forms in jazz? All of the standard song forms are complete and self-contained within a small number of measures, usually 32. There's only a small number of such forms to remember, and each form is simple enough that players can easily keep the entire structure in mind while improvising. This is what makes these forms so useful for jazz. Longer, more complex forms would require special skills to navigate, making collective improvisation more difficult. The restrictions imposed by the standard song forms severely limit, among other things, the amount of harmonic exploration that can be accomplished within the scope of these forms. They simply are not long enough to allow the construction of pieces having sections in several different keys. As a result, the harmonic innovators of the jazz tradition, like Art Tatum, Duke Ellington, Thelonious Monk, Bill Evans, and John Coltrane, among others, have focused their harmonic imagination on the development of novel chord progressions and distinctive chord voicings and sonorities, musical ideas that can be realized in a relative short piece. So, please now go and complete the assignment to go along with this week's lesson. All you'll have to do is listen to a bunch of different songs and tell us whether they are in ABA form, AABA form, ABAC form, through composed. Then next month we're going to start in on the harmonic structure of jazz, now that we have some chord information and some structure. We'll see you in December. Have a great month.